Hello student, welcome to our electrical YouTube channel. And our subject is electrical material and wiring practice. So we start our new chapter, electrical insulating material. First of all, we see the syllabus of that unit. In this unit, first we study the significance and properties of electrical insulating material. Property as electrical property, mechanical property and thermal property of insulating material. Next, the thermal classification of insulating material and classes of insulator on the basis of thermal stability. Next point including the syllabus is dielectric failure of insulating material, that means gaseous, liquid and solid state. Last point is application of insulating material in electrical machines and devices. So start our syllabus. First of all, you see what is meant by insulator. The material which offer very high resistance to the flow of electric current are called as insulator. Next, the property, we see the property of insulator, three properties: electrical property, mechanical and thermal. We see one by one. First we see electrical property. It should have high insulation resistance so that leakage current is less. In case of cable insulation, insulation resistance decreases with increase in temperature and moisture. Next, further insulation resistance is inversely proportional to the length of cable. Insulation resistance is of the two type, namely first insulation resistance is the volume resistance and another is the surface resistance. Volume resistance is the resistance offered to flow of current through unit cube of material. Next, surface resistance is, it is a resistance offered to the current flow over the surface of insulating material. Next, it should be low dielectric losses. It should have high value of direct strength so that it withstand higher voltage without breakdown. It should be low permittivity. You should have low power factor for measurement of any power loss. Next, we see the mechanical property of insulating material. Mechanical property play a vital role in selection of good insulating material. This property impact strength, toughness, high tensile strength, elongation, hardness, flexibility, abrasions. It should be considered for proper selection of insulating material. Viscosity is important property in liquid dielectric used in varnishes and impregnation. An insulating material should possess low porosity to avoid moisture absorption and should not affect the electric property. Solubility decide the working ability of insulating material. Next, mechanical property state. It should have good mechanical strength so withstand vibration when using a electrical machine. Mechanical strength of insulating material depend upon factor like as temperature rise, atmospheric condition. Next property is a thermal property of insulating material, in which include thermal stability, melting point, flash point, volatility, thermal expansion and heat resistance. Thermal stability. Insulating material use must be stable within the allowed temperature. Subjected to high temperature for short and continuous time. Melting point. The temperature of insulating material should be more than the operating temperature for a particular application. Next, flash point. Flash point means flash point of liquid dielectric is that temperature at which the liquid begins to ignite. This property play an important role in selection of oil for transformer, switchgear and other oil immerse apparatus. The insulating material should be non-inflammable. Next is volatility. Insulation material should not exhibit volatile property since it can't act as a good insulator. It should have high thermal conductivity, thermal expansion. The insulating material should exhibit less thermal expansion as it causes formation of voids. These voids breakdown formation play major role in the phenomenon. Heat resistance. The insulating materials will have more heat resistance, thereby making the apparatus capable of handling more power. Next, we start the classification of insulating material. First class of insulating material is thermal withstand ability. Next class is physical state, such as solid state, liquid state and gaseous state. Next third class is structure of material, such as cellulose fibers. Next class is organic or inorganic compounds. Another class is nature or synthetic manufacture. We see our first class, thermal withstand ability. In this class, the insulating material are classified into 7 categories. That means first class is a Y class, second class is a class, third one class is a E class, fourth one is a B class, fifth one is F class, sixth one is H class, and last one, that means seventh one, is C class. This 7 class is totally depend upon limiting temperature range. We see first class. Our first class is a Y class. The limiting temperature for Y class is 90 degree Celsius. The material included in this class is cotton, silk, paper and similar organic material, neither impregnated nor immersed in any oil, rubber and PVC. Our next class is class A and its limiting temperature range is 105 degree Celsius. The material included in this class is impregnated paper, silk, cotton. Our next class is, third one class is E class, and its limiting temperature range is 120 degree Celsius. The material included in this class is enamel wire insulation on base of polyvinyl formal, epoxy resins, moldings, powder, plastics. Our next, fourth class is a class B, and its limiting temperature range is 130 degree Celsius. The material included in this class is inorganic material, for example mica, asbestos, glass fiber, impregnated with varnishes and other compound. Okay, our next class is Fifth class, F class, and its limiting temperature range is 155 degree Celsius. The material included in this class is mica, polyester, varnishes, epoxide, and other varnishes with high heat resistance. Our 6-1 class is H class, and its limiting temperature range is 180 degree Celsius. The material included in this class is composite material of mica, fiberglass, asbestos base impregnated with silicon rubber, except other rubber compound. Our 7-1 or last class is C class, and its limiting temperature range is above 180 degree Celsius. The material included in this class is mica, ceramics, Teflon, quartz, and mica nights. Okay. Remaining classes we see in next video. Thank you.